The world was caught by surprise with the announcement of the first honeybee vaccine against Penicillium larvae, an important honeybee bacterial disease better known as American foulbrood. However, what beekeepers might not realize is the potential of this same vaccine to help against other honeybee problems, including diseases transmitted by the terrible parasite Varroa mite. The company behind this groundbreaking vaccine, Dalan Animal Health, has opened up new possibilities for bee health. By developing a method to vaccinate bees, they have paved the way for potential solutions to a range of threats facing our vital pollinators. The intriguing part, and perhaps the part few people understand, is that the same vaccine against one single bacterium might indeed help against other pathogens as well. But Umberto, how in the world is that possible? We humans need one specific vaccine for each disease out there. Yes, you are correct. However, insect immunity differs from mammalian immunity, and researchers might be able to capitalize on these differences. To explain this, I need to provide a brief overview of the honeybee's immune system and how the vaccine functions. Insects primarily rely on innate immunity, which offers a rapid, non-specific response to pathogens. This includes physical barriers like the exoskeleton, cellular responses such as phagocytosis by hemocytes, and humoral responses, the production of antimicrobial peptides. When a pathogen penetrates the honeybee's body, either through feeding or injection into the hemolymph by Varroa mites, the honeybee's immune cells recognize them. This recognition triggers various molecular pathways that activate defense genes. These genes produce antimicrobial peptides, creating harsh conditions for the microbe to survive inside the honeybee. In humans, we have an additional level of protection. Mammals not only have innate immunity, similar to insects, one good example is fever, but also have something that we call it adaptive immunity. This involves a specific response to pathogens, including the development of memory cells and the production of antibodies, providing long-term immunity. A good example to differentiate them is to think like this. Innate immunity is more general, like a soldier trying to hurt his enemies using heat. In this case, everything in the surroundings will be affected, while the adaptive immunity is more like a sniper that will shoot only a specific target and nothing else. The vaccines we, humans, are used to are based on adaptive immunity. Each vaccine is specific for each pathogen to create long-lasting memory cells specific to each disease, protecting us. When we are vaccinated against chickenpox, for example, if the virus causing chickenpox, a herpes virus called varicella zoster, enters our body, our immune system has mini snipers waiting specifically for that virus. If another kind of virus enters, those little snipers won't do anything against it. When we vaccinate ourselves, we develop several mini snipers inside our body ready to take specific pathogens they are trained to do. However, the honeybee vaccine works differently. Here is how it works. The honeybee queen is fed small pieces of the bacteria that cause American foulbrood disease. These pieces accumulate in the fat bodies of the honeybee queen, which are used to produce honeybee eggs. Every new honeybee in the vaccinated colony will have pieces of this bacteria. These pieces will be recognized by the innate immune system and activate the genes that create harsh conditions for invasive bacteria to replicate. Please note that this is the key to protection. These pieces of bacteria activate the immune system without the presence of the bacteria itself. And if the actual bacteria show up, they will find already harsh conditions for survival, making it much harder for them to establish a full infection. A vaccinated honeybee queen will generate a population of honeybees with reduced chances of getting American foulbrood. But how can this vaccine also protect against other diseases? This is the part that I'm most interested in at the moment. The vaccine temporarily triggers the innate immune system of the honeybees. The activated response to the vaccine could potentially create problems for other pathogens to infect the vaccinated honeybees, something that we are calling cross-protection. This is how the vaccine might help against varroa mite infestation and potentially other honeybee pathogens. Take varroa mite for example. Varroa mite feeds on the fat bodies and hemolymph of the honeybees, transmitting several deadly viruses in the process. If some of these viruses are affected by the already activated immune system of the honeybees triggered by the vaccine, these viruses will have a hard time to establish themselves. It would be amazing, for example, if you could see the deformed wing virus, the most dangerous honeybee virus today, having its replication compromised somehow by the effect of the vaccine. A lot of the problems with varroa, in my opinion, come more from the diseases it transmits than from the feeding itself. If the vaccine can reduce the ability of the deformed wing virus to infect honeybees, or any other virus transmitted by varroa mites, this would be a significant contribution to overall honeybee health, providing great value for the customer. Honeybees are in constant battle against pests, diseases, and exposure to toxic chemicals. This constant fight takes a lot of the resources of the honeybee colony that could have been used for other tasks, such as honey production. If the vaccine could diminish or even eliminate some of these variables, the honeybees wouldn't have to expend energy on them and would likely be stronger to accomplish the tasks they need to fulfill, honey production and pollination, for example. I'm a big fan of using technology to find innovative solutions for our daily problems. However, I want to take a step back here and do a little reminder to everybody out there that we are talking in hypotheticals here, and the vaccine will prove its value when more people start to use it and more data can be accumulated. The potential of this vaccine is tremendous, but for now, only time and more research will confirm all the speculations that I'm making here. I hope this video addresses some of the frequent questions I've received from you guys. If not, please continue to ask in the comment section and I will do my best to respond. I would like to thank my members for their support and you for watching. Inside the Hive.tv, the show about bees. See you guys next week.